Muatu Jamir Abni Ghasasi Hornbill TV, Itia Headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi pra aji nation ke khota kwa homoi vaccine do centralized kurubule announced kurishi. State laga 25% vaccination kam do center pra sabo kurishi. PM pra aru kurishi June 21 pra 18 sal opor kan sop ke free vaccine dibule shuru kurubo aru vaccine bishi kuri dibule khota dishi. Indian Space Research Development Pra Tinta Type Ventilators Develop Kurishe COVID-19 Larai Kuribule. Central Board of Secondary Education Pra Kurishe Class 12 Practical Exam Do Online Mode Te Hobo Aro June 28 Agede Marks Do Upload Kuribule Announced Kurishe. Junta pra hatai dia Myanmar laga leader Aung San Suu Kyi laga trial aya haftare shuru kuribole ase koikina tai laga lawyer pra khobor junai dishe. Itia pandemic homoide citizens khan pra tai khan laga complaints register kuribole laga challenges face kuria khange asan kuribole karne Twensang police khan pra jamoina feedback box ekta launch kurishe. Itude public khan pra tai khan laga complaints suggestions noile feedbacks kan paper de likhi gina police kan logode share korobole paria lagase itu feedback box se complaints or feedbacks kan ahia do Twensang laga superintendent of police Amit Nigam pra directly monitor kuri ase Twensang police pra itu feedback box to Twensang town de pasta jagade thali gina ase aro itu box to hotai din 6 baji morning nishna de check kuri kuise itu feedback box thali gina thage do kiniga jai ase itu janibole karni ami kan itia Twensang laga SP logode khota korobo.
Guest with us, we have Sir Amit Nigam, IPS. He's the superintendent of police Twensang. So thank you so much, sir, for joining us today. We understand that you have a very busy schedule, but thank you so much for giving us your time, sir.
Thank you for having me, and I wish all the very best to Hornbill TV for such a nice initiative, because as a news agency, we were lacking some news agency in Nagaland. So now we have our own news agency, and my heartiest congratulations to Hornbill TV.
Thank you so much, sir. So, sir, moving on with our conversation, since you have been posted in Twensang, so we would want to know how long have you been posted there, and also we'd want to know your experience working there, sir.
Actually, this is my third month. I was posted here in March, mid of March.
Okay.
But now, and so far so good. We are working hard. I was posted during the by-elections, so the by-election went uncontested here, and then now we are facing a pandemic, and we are trying our best to implement the lockdown in letter and spirit, and so far we are able to control everything.
Okay, sir. So last month, the Twensang police came up with the idea of setting up a feedback, complaint or suggestion box, sir. So we'd like to know, how did you come up with that idea, sir?
Actually, this idea came out during the pandemic only, when people were forced, or you can say due to lockdown, were not allowed to come out of their home. So we were seeing that there was a lack of footfall in our thanas, or people were not able to approach us, and there were cases of theft or domestic violence, which were not this, because people were not allowed to come out of their home. So we thought that we should find some type of a mechanism in which, if people are not able to reach us, at least we can. So we came out with an idea of feedback box, and we installed a feedback box at some prominent places where the footfall of the people is quite well. When there is a leniency given during the lockdown, so during that time people can come and give their complaint, feedback and suggestion in those feedback box.
Okay,
so this pandemic, to bridge the gap between the citizen and the police, we came up with that idea.
Okay, So, it's also would like to know if setting up a helpline number where the masses could call in and send in their comments and suggestions ever crossed your mind, because since we know that it's quite difficult to get out of our houses and it's not that safe as well. So, we'd like to know about that too, sir.
Sorry, I didn't get you your question.
Okay, sir.
There was some disturbance.
Okay, so we would like to know if setting up a helpline number where the masses could call in and give in their comments or suggestions ever crossed your mind, because we know that it's quite not safe for people to get out of their houses also at this point of time.
No, actually we have a police control room number which is working in Tunsan. But people are not well aware about that number. And people don't even have the connectivity, as we have poor connectivity across Tunsan.
Yes,
so we were not the required calls from the people. So they were not able to contact us through the landline or through the mobile phone. So we thought that if we can install some physical structure like feedback box, where people can anonymously come and give their feedback, complaint or suggestions. So because people have an inhibition, people don't want to come in front and let us know that what suggestion they want to make or any complaint they have. Yeah. So this gives a little bit of anonymity to the people also. So they can anonymously come and give their feedback and suggestion. And this feedback and suggestion box are directly controlled by the crime branch SP office Tunsan. So it is directly monitored by me. So we take prompt action for complaint or suggestion we get.
Okay.
Get over time.
So how has the response been so far?
The response has been mixed. But recently you would have seen that we have arrested five carders of huge underground people.
Yes, sir.
Extortion. We got this lead from one of our feedback only.
Yes, sir.
So there was a complaint regarding that. That I'll not go into the details,
yes,
but
sir.
I'll give you an overview. We got a complaint regarding that through our feedback box. So that was like a lead. So that gave us a lead, and we worked upon that information, and we were able to apprehend five people who were involved in extortion.
So we don't want to know if the suggestion box are being checked on a daily basis or how many times a week or a month, sir?
Feedback box are checked on daily basis.
Okay. Sir.
So this response has been given to my quick response team on the daily round in the morning around 6. They check the feedback box on the daily basis.
Okay, sir. So how many complaints or suggestions do you receive in a day, approximately?
It depends. Some feedback box are yet to see any complaint or feedback, and some we get 10, 5, 20. It's like it varies. It varies.
Okay, sir. So we'd also want to know what are the most common common suggestions or complaints that you receive in the feedback box, sir.
Most common suggestion which we receive is it's like you can say, sir, suggestion or a complaint in which people complain about illegal taxation.
Yes,
people are not happy with illegal taxation or extortion. So we have form a team. My crime branch anti-extortion team is involved in that. They are looking into those complaints, and we will bring justice to that.
Yes, sir. So also, like you have mentioned before, according to studies, domestic violence is one of the most common crime during this pandemic. So has there been any cases of domestic violence being reported, sir?
That regard, in our feedback box.
Yes, sir. So what other steps are taken after that, sir?
For what?
For domestic violence, for cases of domestic violence as such, sir.
Women police station in Tunsan. We have a very efficient woman OC, and she is directed to promptly address all those issues whichever come to their notice. Whenever there is any distress call from any women or any female, we take it very seriously and it is addressed very promptly.
Sir, also, has there been any changes in cases being reported before and after setting up the feedback, a suggestion box, sir?
Actually, it would be too early because it's been near about not even a fortnight we have installed these. So it would be very early to comment on that.
Okay,
but we are very hopeful that we will definitely get good results and it will bridge the gap between the citizen and the police.
Also, sir, with, you know, moving forward the conversation, we'd also want to know what is the crime rate during this pandemic, sir? Is it decreasing or increasing as of Tuen Sang, sir?
If you talk about the crime rate, it has decreased because we have implemented the lockdown in letter and spirit. So we have not allowed the antisocial elements to be on the road. So the crime rates have decreased. Yes, it has decreased over the period of time.
Yes, sir, we'd want to know what are the challenges in maintaining law and order during this pandemic?
Actually, it's a huge challenge itself. Pandemic, this COVID second wave is a huge pandemic itself. This time we made it clear that we will implement the lockdown in letter and spirit. During the district task force meetings, we made it very clear to the general people and the local leaders and the tribal leaders that they have to be very cooperative with us and they have to make the people understand that police as a force, we are working for them. They should not take us as their enemies. We are here to help them. So far, all the local people have cooperated with us and we are able to implement the lockdown in a very proper way.
Okay, sir. So also moving forward, we would want to know how many police personnel have been deployed solely for COVID duties in Tuen Sang?
There is no differentiation done so far. All the thanas, all my OCs and all the senior officers, including me, we are always on ground when it comes to COVID duties.
Yes, so we also want to know how many police personnel have contracted the virus during their duty, or are there any special benefits given to them?
So far, if we talk about Tuen Sang, we have 10 active cases as of now, today.
Yes,
and they all are asymptomatic and they are doing well. We personally keep a note of them and I personally call them and know their well-being, and we assure them that the entire DEF stands with them in this testing time. And so far we have not seen any eventuality with God's grace, and hopefully we will fight back.
So sir, you're saying 10 police personnel have tested positive for the virus, or?
They are tested positive and they are asymptomatic and they are stable and they are.
Okay, sir. So also, we'd want to know how is the interaction between the local bodies and the police been so far?
We have a very healthy interaction with them. They have been very welcoming and cooperative with us. They understand the responsibilities also, that we have to work in a very legal framework. They understand our limitations also.
Mm-hmm.
And we are very happy that they are very cooperative and understanding towards police.
Okay, sir. So also coming to an end of this conversation, sir, I would want to ask, in your opinion, how has the pandemic changed the functioning of the police, sir, as a whole?
If we look into the entirety, this pandemic have helped us to build up our image. Earlier, people used to distrust us as a police force, I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
But now people understand that we are also human and part of the society.
Mm-hmm.
And we are there for them. They have understood that we had been standing with them, beside them in this tough times. So, mm-hmm. The trust level have increased between the people and the police. And this pandemic has been very harsh if we talk about on the human fatalities and all, but it has been very good in building up the understanding between police and the local people.
Okay, sir. So is there anything you would want to share to our viewers, sir?
I would just say that we as a police organization, wherever we are in Twin Sang or in any other district of Nagaland, we are there for you. We are just a call away. We are there standing beside you in all the tough situations, and people should come forward and cooperate with us.
Okay, sir. So thank you so much for joining us today, sir. It was a pleasure having you, and we'd want to wish a very, you know, successful future for you, sir. And thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me. I just want to add on to all the viewers of you, stay home, stay safe, please.